like a refresher after a week off?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I'm 31, so they give me a week off and, you know, put my feet in the sand. You know, definitely feel rejuvenated, refreshed. But nah, man, on a serious note, you know, obviously we not where we want to be right now, 5-5. But we got a good opportunity this week. Play a, you know, divisional rival. You know, it's going to be a hyped up game. I'm sure those guys want to see us as, you know, bad as we want to see them. But you know, definitely want to finish this, you know, back half of the season, you know, on a positive note, a strong note, and just continue to kind of hold our place, you know, in the division, you know, as number one.
Last year, I think Ritter made his first start against you all. What do you remember from that game? And just on film, how much have you seen him grow that he'll be starting again?
I mean, to be honest, man, you see a lot of things he do well. It's things that, you know, we kind of struggle with, you know, the last, you know, 4 or 5 weeks. So, you know, they're going to put him in the center. They'll put him in the gun. You know, they're going to obviously get him outside the pocket, you know, give him, you know, three option play, you know, as we call it. You know, he can throw it away, he can run it, or he can throw it to somebody. So, you know, our hands will be full with that. And so just looking forward to it. Obviously, we got a bad taste in our mouth with, you know, quarterbacks of his caliber. So it's going to be a big, big challenge for us this week.
I just have one more question. You were at the Heisman ceremony, obviously, with Jaden Daniels, you know, potentially another LSU player winning it. How closely do you follow that? And what would you tell him about just kind of being up there in the whole moment, assuming he's going to be invited and potentially even win it?
Yeah, I mean, I'm pretty sure his eyes was much better than mine was. You know, I think he's pretty much, you know, in the driver's seat, you know, right now. You know, for me, I just went out there, man, for the glitz and glamour. You know what I mean? I knew I probably wasn't winning it, so I was just trying to enjoy it, you know, as much as I can. But, you know, he's had a phenomenal year. You know, obviously I follow LSU closely, but, you know, definitely feel like he's one of those players that, you know, really, man, has kind of come into his own, you know, over the course of his career. So, you know, hats off to him, man. Hats off to, you know, all the people over there coaching him up. So, but, yeah, most definitely want to see him, you know, bring it back to the Bayou.
Tyrann, have you told James to vote for him?
You know what? I forgot James had a vote. Shame on me, but I'll definitely be putting that bargain in there for sure.
Tyrann, last game was the first game that you guys didn't have a takeaway this season. How much has that been discussed or a point of focus in getting back in that, you know, in that category again this next game?
Yeah, I mean, it's important. You know, every game in the NFL is a close football game. You know, sometimes you kind of able to run away with the score. So, you know, when we played the Vikings, you know, it came down to the wire. It was not a close game. So, you know, I think when you look back on, you know, all the games, but especially those games that you lose, you know, by one score, right, like you're always a turnover or a takeaway, you know, away from, you know, putting your team in position to win the game. So, you know, we back on it. We've been preaching and harping it really all year. You know, I think this back half of the season, man, we really got to do a better job. And I thought we did a great job of taking the ball away. But, you know, if we could kind of take it up a notch, you know, I think we'll be right where we need to be, you know, going into the end of the season and, you know, hopefully the playoffs.
Is there that renewed focus again of trying to get that consistency? I know, you know, Dale was talking about during that bye week about how, you know, first five, you know, how the defense, you know, compared to the last five
right
before that break. Is that kind of the renewed focus again, trying to get that consistency back on defense?
Yeah, man. You know, obviously we started the season off really well and, you know, kind of played well here and there. You know, wasn't really good enough, you know, especially in the back end. You know, gave up a ton of touchdowns and, you know, a ton of passing yards. So, you know, if we can just get back to, you know, playing how we know we can play, you know, we'll be all right. I don't think there's really no panic in that, but it is a sense of urgency. You know, you don't realize sometimes that you're kind of on a decline, right? You know, that was kind of good that, you know, to have that pointed out to us.
How much would you miss a guy like Marshawn with secondary, miss a guy like that?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I mean, any team he's on, man, they going to miss him. You know, not many guys in this league can cover how you can cover. And just his presence alone, right, like can scare a quarterback away from making certain throws. So, you know, we'll definitely miss his presence if he's not able to go with us. But, you know, feel like we have – you know, enough guys in the room that, you know, we can get it done.
I know every game is important, but is there like a heightened sense of urgency for this game?
Oh, yeah, 100%. Listen, man, 5-5, like every game from here on out is, you know, extremely important. You know, I think how we practice and prepare, you know, extremely important, and how we finish the game too. And we've been doing a decent job at that, but, you know, we just, like I said, man, we just got to find a way to kind of put it together for four quarters and really help this team, you know, win.
Sorry, no worries.